God of power and mercy and love, you sent your Son, that we might be cleansed of sin and live with you forever. Bless us all as we have gathered to reflect on his suffering and his death, that we might learn from his example in all the ways that we should go. Jesus came with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took along Peter and the two sons of Zebedee and began to feel sorrow and distress. Then he said to them, "My soul is sorrowful even to death. Remain here and keep watch with me." He advanced a little and fell prostrate in prayer, saying, "My Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Yet not as I will, but as you will." He returned to his disciples and he found them asleep. He said to Peter, "So you could not keep watch with me for just an hour? Watch and pray that you may not undergo the test. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." Then, while Jesus was speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, accompanied with a crowd of swords and clubs, who'd come from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. His betrayer had arranged a signal with them, saying, "The man I kiss is the one. Arrest him and lead him away securely." He came and immediately went over to him and said, "Rabbi," and he kissed him. At this, they laid hands on him and arrested him. When the day came, the council of the elders and the people met, both chief priests and scribes, and they brought him before the Sanhedrin. They said, "If you are the Messiah, tell us." But he replied to them, "If I tell you, you will not believe. And if I question, you will not respond. But from this, the Son of Man will be seated at the right hand of the power of God." They all asked, "Are you the Son of God?" He replied to them, "You say that I am." And they said, "What further need have we for this testimony? We've heard it from his own mouth." Now Peter was sitting outside of the courtyard. One of the maids came over to him and said, "You too were here with Jesus the Galilean." But he denied it in front of everyone, saying, "I do not know what you're talking about." As he went out of the gate, another girl saw him and said to those who were there, "This man was with Jesus the Nazarene." Again, he denied it with an oath, "I do not know the man." A little later, the bystanders came over and said to Peter, "Surely, you too are one of them. Even your speech gives you away." At this, he began to curse and to swear, "I do not know the man." And immediately, the cock crowed. Then Peter remembered the word Jesus had spoken, "Before the cock crows, you will deny me three times." He went out and began to weep bitterly. The chief priests with the elders and scribes, that is the whole Sanhedrin, held a council. They bound Jesus and they led him away. They handed him over to Pilate. Pilate questioned him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" He said to him in reply, "You say so." The chief priests accused him of many things. Again, Pilate questioned him, "Have you no answer? See how many of these things we accuse you of?" Jesus gave him no further answer, so that Pilate was amazed. Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas and handed Jesus over to be crucified. Then Pilate took Jesus and had him scourged. The soldiers wove a crown of thorns and placed it on his head, clothed him in a purple cloak, and they came out and said to him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" And they struck him repeatedly. When the chief priests and the guards saw Christ, they cried out, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" Pilate said to them, "Take him yourself and crucify him. I find no guilt in him." They cried out, "Take him away. Take him away. Crucify him." Pilate said to them, "Shall I crucify your king?" The chief priests answered, "We have no king but Caesar." Then he handed him over to them to be crucified. So they took Jesus, and carrying the cross himself, he went out to what is called the place of the skull, in Hebrew, Golgotha. A large crowd of people followed Jesus, including many women who mourned and lamented him. Jesus turned to them and said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me. Weep instead for yourselves and for your children. For indeed the days are coming when the people will say, 'Blessed are the barren, the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never nursed.' At that time, people will say to the mountains, 'Fall upon us,' and the hills, 'Cover us.' For if these things are done when the wood is green, what will happen when it is dry?" When they came to the place called the skull, they crucified him. And the criminals there, one on his right, the other on his left. Now one of the criminals hanging there reviled Jesus and said, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." The other, however, rebuking him, said in reply, "Have you no fear of God? For you were subject to the same condemnation, and indeed we have been condemned justly. For the sentence we receive corresponds to our crimes. But this man has done nothing criminal." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied to him, "Amen. I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother, his mother's sister, Mary the wife of Cleopas, and Mary of Magdala. When Jesus saw his mother and his disciples there whom he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." From that hour, the disciple took her into his home. It was about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. because of an eclipse of the sun. And the veil of the temple was torn down the middle. Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Father, unto your hands I commit my spirit." When he'd said this, he breathed his last. When it was evening, there came a rich man from Arimathea named Joseph, who was himself a disciple of Jesus. He went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus, and Pilate ordered it to be handed over. Taking the body, Joseph wrapped it in clean linen and laid it in his new tomb that he had hewn in the rock. Then he rolled a huge stone across the entrance of the tomb and departed. Lord Jesus, this passion and death is the thing that unites us to heaven. It's reconciled all people to you. We've faithfully attempted to reflect upon all of these mysteries. Help us to follow in your steps, so that we too can share that glory in heaven with you. Thank you for this ultimate sacrifice you've made for us. In your name, amen.